Inviting Mr. Menon for a quick charged brief on what he want to talk about the other side. We were listening to DDA and authorities, now this is the other side. Mr. Ramesh Menon from Certes Reality, and after that we'll be opening for 20 minutes question answers and try to squeeze in the next session quickly. We're shifting the lunch to 2 p.m. Kindly bear with us. Thank you.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Ram Ram. That's a good landowners group. Okay, I really want to reiterate all the good things we've heard since morning. But let me ask you a question. I'm not blaming DDA on any front. I'm just raising a discordant note. India, we said, is growing and is bound to do a lot of good, nice things in the future. But the capital of India possibly is the only capital in the world where we say we have regularized 4,500 unauthorized colonies. Where we have nomenclature like authorized, unauthorized colonies and unauthorized, authorized colonies. Now, why has all this come up? The reason I throw it in front of you is so that, you know, the entire think tank of DDA is here. Why not us raise these questions and find some answers and also make sure that these are incorporated in the final decisions that DDA takes or the ministry takes, so that most of us who have invested millions and maybe much more do not get stuck with the land that we have bought. I personally know about 50 to 75 people in this group who own land in Delhi, developers, individuals, HNIs. Did we invest into this land to possibly get stuck? There are at least 50 people here who have come to know whether they should invest in land today. Now, two things. Delhi Land Reform Act 1954 was created much before DDA came into being. The MCD came into being in 1957 and DDA in 57-58. Now, we all experience it, those of us who have bought land here. Ek dadaji the 50 ke dashak mein, 60 ke dashak mein. Unke char bete ho gaye, char ke teen bete ho gaye. Aaj us zameen ke 12 hissedar hain. Aur wo aapas mein baat nahi karte. But I go and buy land from two of those brothers. Aur meri zameen ka taqseem hone nahi deti revenue department ke niyam. So I am stuck with them, they are stuck with me. In one of the meetings with DDA, I was told that hum to ji saaf sutri zameen lenge. Ek niyam to aapka meri zameen ko saaf hone nahi deti. Aur dusri taraf kya aap mere joint shareholding ko land pooling mein accept karenge. If that is the case, then 50% of the land in Delhi is jointly held. Even when we pool in money together, even if we all pool in money together, hum kehte hain sab 5-5 lakh rupaye milate hain aur hum zameen ikatthe khareedte hain, we are all joint holders. So what is the way out under the land pooling policy? So I just thought I'll red flag that. The other is the many notices of Section 81 that the Revenue Department is issuing these days. Iji, aapne sadak bana di, to Section 81 ka notice, aur aapki zameen ko hum kabza kar rahe hain. Or we are reclaiming the land because you put it to unlawful use. On the one hand, we are talking about 96 villages which are supposed to be in the land pooling to be converted into urban land. But we are applying the rules of the rural land on them. How many of here of the people here are harassed under Section 33 or Section 81? Yeah, I see a few hands. A lot of them are not raising the hand possibly to say ki chal chodo yaar kya panga lena. But that's okay. I mean, let's raise these so that these get included in the final draft of the suggestions that go from this room to the think tank. The other is, under this same very law, suddenly we have created new Frankensteins called Gram Sabha. Yeh DC office hai, yeh SDM office hai, Tehsildar office hai, aur kanun ko office hai. On the one hand, we are talking about licensing to come under one single window. What will happen to the multiple windows that we have created for land pooling? Is there a move from the government to bring all these windows under one ambit? Unless that happens, this land pooling, yes, we are all invested, but this land pooling might remain a pipe dream. It is good on a PPT presentation. I am very excited when I see Ms. Alka's presentation, 2 saal, 3 mahine, 4 mahine, etc., etc., etc. But the 60% clause will get stuck. So here is what I suggest, and I am volunteering this in front of a public forum. It is not just the suit-clad people in this room who are landowners. 50% of the land still possibly is with the farmer, the desi jat like me. Who will communicate with them on the very efficient system, robust, that we are going to set up? Somebody has to be going and talking to them. So in the villages that I hail from, we volunteer that we will go and spread this news. But the DDA, can you give us an official sanction to communicate on your behalf? The operational mechanism that you have released, maaf karna sahab, zamindar ek fard ko dekh ke dar jata hai ki kahin pata nahi kya usme karigiri na kar de. Aapne to 56 page ka document de diya form bharne ke liye angrezi mein. So will somebody go and tell him, hey, I am on your side, I'll help you, I'll fill up the forms, main sara kuch karunga, because the DDA has officially allowed me. Why will he accept me? Because I am one of his land owners. And why not have 3, 4, 5 agencies like this of the same social fabric who will convince these people to pool in the land? उसको उसकी भाषा में अगर उसका बेनिफिट समझा दें तो शायद आ भी जाएगा. नहीं तो वी ऑल नो, पीपल फ्रॉम दिल्ली विल नो, बाप मेरी जमीन तो नहीं बिकती, मैं ना देता. दैट्स द एंड ऑफ लैंड पूलिंग. वन मोर पॉइंट, जस्ट वन मोर पॉइंट. अगेन आई हर्ड समबडी से दैट 4 पीपल कम टुगेदर एंड दे विल बी कंसिडर अ डेवलपर एंटिटी. आई आस्क यू दिस, 4 local jats with not even a metric on his educational qualification, yes, they can put together 10, 15, 20 acres of land. Would you consider them a developer entity? If yes, what are the capabilities? Yes, I am sure they will also have the ability to give you the EDC, IDC, or the bank guarantees. What are the criteria that DDA would apply for people to evolve as developer entity? Anybody who's got land cannot be a developer entity, because they have to sell in the retail. What presumptions would you take that somebody who owns land and has deposited the bank guarantees can develop a 30-storied